we finally have some more details and a greater look at Dune 2020, thanks to some newly released images and interviews with the cast in the latest edition of Empire magazine. In particular, we got a range of different photos showcasing the scale and intimacy between the characters, alongside some new information on the production. In this video, I'm going to be discussing these reveals and breaking down the newest looks at the film. Before I get into it though, if you want to see much more videos on Dune, including my trailer breakdown coming on September the 9th, then don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn on your notifications. Also, if you enjoy this video, remember to leave a like rating. Without further ado, let's dive into the latest details in the Empire edition of Dune. With spice, sandworms, and scale, Denis Villeneuve's Dune is an epic and daring new take on the famous novel with an incredible cast. With Empire's new magazine issue, we get up close to find out how the director and his crew are undertaking the project. Now, you've probably seen the Empire covers, but since I'm doing a full video on all of the images, I will start with these. On the first cover, we have a collective photo of Timothee Chalamet's young Paul Atreides, Oscar Isaac as his father, Duke Leto, Rebecca Ferguson as the Bene Gesserit witch, Lady Jessica, and Josh Brolin's Master-at-Arms, Gurney Halleck. On the second cover, we got an alternative look at the Fremen of the planet Arrakis. This includes Javier Bardem's Stilgar, leader of one of the Fremen tribes, and Zendaya's tribe master Chaney. Then there's Sharon Duncan Brewster as Liette Kynes, and Jason Momoa's Duncan Idaho, who isn't a Fremen, but whose destiny may ultimately lie with them. The final cover that was revealed earlier in the week, which was created exclusively for Empire in collaboration with the filmmakers behind Dune, is a terrifying glimpse at the colossal sandworms of Arrakis, with one threatening to swallow Paul Atreides. It will be interesting to see if the full trailer gives us a first look in motion of the sandworms, but this image definitely gives us a good taste at their appearance. Moving on to the full set of new photos, we get a look at Paul and Chaney together for the first time, and I'm guessing that this will be taking place soon after they meet at the Fremen camp, and after Paul and Jessica survive in the desert. More photos include Duke Leto and Gurney Halleck, soon after they arrive on Arrakis, Stilgar and the Fremen, as well as Leto and his concubine Lady Jessica. What I like about all of these images so far is that whether they are interior or exterior shots, Villeneuve seems to be capturing his traditional essence of filmmaking through natural lighting and making the characters stand out through the expression shown in their costume design. The detail that needs to go into a project like this needs to be high, and Denis is perfect for that. Earlier on in the week, we also got an extra image displaying an action-filled scene with Duncan Idaho, and many are starting to believe that he is fighting the Harkonnen troops, disguised as the Sardaukar. The reason that this is being pointed out is because we have had some other images released today with the actual magazine, and one of them shows us an enormous shot of scope and scale with Harkonnen troops surrounding what appears to be a statue in the distance and ships at either side of the frame. The troops themselves seem to be wearing similar uniforms to the previous picture, but right now it's difficult to conclude on. We also get a broad shot of Arrakis with what looks to be Paul and Lady Jessica, with the film being described as one of the most daring science fiction movies in decades. Another image includes Paul and Helen Moheim during one of the opening scenes, which was shown in the teaser trailer. I did do a video describing this, and I'm sure that the full trailer next week will also show more glimpses of this sequence. There's another shot of Paul and Jessica with Chaney and Stilgar after they join the Fremen camp, and Liette Kynes at the Arrakeen residency hall on Arrakis. In the last set of photos released today, we got another look at the training sequence with Gurney and what appears to be a glow globe in the background and a shield generator around the character's wrist, along with another shot of Chalamet and Villeneuve during Paul's preparation for the scene. The final image shows us Paul in front of a worm mural, which appears to be similar to the crew t-shirt that was spotted on set during the production. I'm overall loving the futuristic but also ancient looking designs from all of these interior sets. They echo what was released in the previous Empire magazine and other looks that have leaked from the set. But alongside these images, the director and crew shared some thoughts on the production with some interesting details to point out. Chalamet stated that the filming in southern Jordan was awe-inspiring, with huge cliff faces and how the filming there wasn't done on green screen. He says that this was one of the most thrilling parts of the book and the movie. He mentions that on Call Me By Your Name or Beautiful Boy, it can be counterintuitive to see the storyboards and sketches because then maybe you limit yourself based on the camera angle. It's the opposite in Dune because for a sequence with a sandworm chasing you, he could never imagine that. For Oscar Isaac, the relevance of Dune and its filming of that through themes also felt clear. He adds that the film is about the destiny of a people and the different way that cultures have dominated over others. He poses the question of how do a people respond when it's at the tipping point, when enough is enough, when they're exploited. He states that we are seeing all of those things around the world right now. Oscar Isaac knew of the novel and Villeneuve and had reached out as soon as he knew the film was happening. He said that when he read the novel again, Leto is the character that stood out to him, not only from the description physically, but also the conflict of wanting to protect his family, his people, but also being forced into an impossible situation that is perilous and yet hoping that he can gain advantage in that. In this magazine, we further got a discussion with Denis Villeneuve, including his reflection on Frank Herbert and the novel itself. For Villeneuve, the book is about prescience, a character that can see the future. He feels that Herbert himself had a pretty good view of the future. People exploiting natural resources with brutality, and other people fighting for the sake of nature. He wants young people in particular to discover this story through the film as he once discovered the book, and to fall in love with Herbert's beautiful ecosystems and unique relationship with nature. This is something that I was saying about the marketing a few months ago, in that they need to capture the imagination of new audiences while respecting the audience that is already there. It's something that will help make the film successful globally, but also beloved as an adaptation on a piece of art. Villeneuve was also keen to showcase his thoughts on Lady Jessica, as he says that he wanted to demonstrate just what she's capable of as a character in this adaptation. He notes that he didn't want Lady Jessica to be an expensive extra. To the director, he deeply loves in the book that there was a strong balance between the masculine power and the feminine power. Based on these new images and quotes from Denis Villeneuve, he definitely seems to be showcasing that and displaying the full range of Lady Jessica's strengths and also the problems she has to deal with. Speaking to Empire, it seems Villeneuve is also fonder of David Lynch's film than Lynch himself, though he still saw a reason to put the focus on his own version. He states that he's a big David Lynch fan and that he remembers being excited and that his take had parts that he loved and other elements that he is less comfortable with. He remembers being half satisfied, and that's why he was thinking that there's still a movie that needs to be made about the book, just from a different sensibility. The final thing that Denis mentions is about the potentiality for a sequel. He says that if this film does work for mass audiences, he hopes to return to tell the rest of Paul Atreides' story. While this film is about a boy losing his innocence and adapting to a new culture, the sequel would see him at full potential as a leader. This is because of the threat posed by the Harkonnens and the danger of the Sands not being entirely diffused in the first film. He does mention, however, that if the film doesn't turn out to be a success, he is happy to at least have had a try. He references Frank Herbert in saying that there is no real ending and that sometimes you need to go all out in the approach you are taking. But that's the main details and images we got in the latest edition of Empire magazine, and it looks like we are going to be getting a good treat come the release of the full-length trailer next week. I'm intrigued to hear what you guys thought towards these new details and images, alongside whether you are liking the style of approach that Denis Villeneuve is taking. So let me know down below in the comment section. For more videos surrounding Dune leading up to its release date, then subscribe to the channel and turn on your notifications. Also, if you enjoyed this video, remember to give it a like rating. I will be covering news and topics for Dune whenever new information comes out, including the trailer releasing on September the 9th, so look out for all of my videos in the coming weeks. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed it. I've been Cortex, and as always, make some noise.